I'm going to talk about Indore model of actually Indore becoming the cleanest city in the country. I was collector of Indore in 2000, from 2015 to 2017. And only till recently, I was the commissioner and secretary of urban administration, municipal administration of Madhya Pradesh. I was recently shifted to another department. So I am going to talk about the initiative of Indore, what Indore did to become three times continuously the cleanest city. And fourth time also, almost we won the results have not been declared, but we are very sure that we would have been the number one. So the things that I am going to talk about is the initiatives taken by the municipal corporation. So I will very clearly clarify that I was only collector at that point of time, and later on now I was municipal administration commissioner. So the work was done by the municipal commissioner of Indore. So all credit goes to the then municipal commissioners and present municipal commissioners who are actually doing wonderful job even today. So I'll just share with you. Okay, so basically what Indore has done is a number of things that we all know. I'm not going to talk something which you guys don't know. Andariki telisinave ivanni, actually a lot of these things you must have learned. I also understand that most of the municipal commissioners of Telangana actually visited Indore also and have actually seen what Indore did. But I'll try to mention briefly a number of initiatives which were taken up by Indore and are continuously being sustained. See, this is the most important thing that we all need to understand in administration, is that sustenance of whatever we are doing, a continuous doing things in a continuous fashion over a long period of time is sustenance. Only such continuous efforts lead to any city, or to that effect, I would say, having been in administration for nearly about 20 years, if you take up a project and if you are able to make it a model out of it and present to the country or the world that how things can be done, the only thing that the reason behind that is sustained effort. So, Indore lo jarigindi ade anamata. There was a plan, and then the plan was executed in a very meticulous way over a period of time. And now, since 2015, there have been four municipal commissioners who were changed in Indore. But still, Indore remains the number one city. It is because of a bouquet of efforts that were made and are continuously being made by Indore Municipal Corporation, and now which is replicated. So here you would see a number of things that are clearly mentioned. So to begin with, it is the efforts begin with door-to-door collection and segregation. This is the most important thing. And as Commissioner Municipal Administration, we have been striving. In Madhya Pradesh, we have 378 urban local bodies. The single most important thing that everybody has to do invariably is door-to-door collection with segregation at source. See, instead of segregating the waste at different levels, it is better to segregate waste at the door-to-door level itself. So wet waste, dry waste, sanitary and domestic hazardous waste are segregated at source itself in entire Indore. And this is another important thing that I would say is a game changer. If there was a game changer as far as Indore is concerned, that is removal of bins in from the city. So the dust bins or the bins where in most of the cities of our country, the major problem is the dustbin, which is kept for people to throw their waste, becomes the biggest dumping yard or biggest unclean place in the city. So the most important initiative that was taken up in Indore was that remove bins, no bins. So Indore is a bin-free city. So today we don't have any bins. So what happens in the absence of bins? 100% door-to-door collection of waste in all wards, and even shops lunch kuda, all shops, business places, market places, bazaar lo, annitlalo, everywhere it has to be door-to-door collection. Nowhere somebody will throw the waste at some place and it is collected. It is not done like that. Then we all understand another important thing is our own Safai Karmacharis. Safai Karmacharis evaraithe untaro, they are the ones who will actually, we need to take them into confidence in order to ensure that this initiative reaches that particular level. So veelani taking them on board under the entire effort lo, they need to be made partners in this whole thing. So we also understand, as far as the Safai Karmacharis are concerned, they are the ones where absenteeism, or to say that rather than absenteeism, instead of being absent, they are non-existent. Non-existent and absenteeism among the Safai Karmacharis is the biggest issue. We know because how their appointment, how they are appointed, who are they appointed by, and in a highly political system like municipalities and municipal corporations. So this becomes rampant. So we need to ensure that each one of them is available and is working. And Aadhaar linked biometric attendance system, smart watch that is actually geotagging each one of these Safai Karmacharis, their work, and beat-based system of deployment of these Safai Karmacharis, and they're newly named as Safai Mitra. So all these things are efforts which have been taken and are continuously being done. So mechanized road sweeping. So major roads, as far as major roads are concerned, most of the major roads are swept by mechanized road sweeping equipment. So minor roads or roads or the roads belonging to colonies and roads which are smaller in width, the traditional sweeping is done, whereas mechanized sweeping is done on all the major roads of Indore. So approximately 2,500 dumpers of dust removed. The RSPM levels of cities got reduced from 145 to 75 to 80. Respiratory airborne diseases are reduced by 70%. In 2016, and first time Indore became the cleanest city, the IMA conducted a survey, Indian Medical Association conducted a survey wherein they said that there is a reduction of 40% OPD in entire Indore city. So that itself shows how simple initiatives or initiatives pertaining to Swachh Bharat can make a huge, huge change. This is then vehicle monitoring, tracking and monitoring system. This is, I would say, well-developed system as of now today. Installation of GPS receivers in more than 700 plus vehicles. Web-based vehicle tracking solution. Dashboard, live vehicle tracking, route replay, admin modules, reports, alerts, integration of entire thing, and integration with weight bridge. So from the door-to-door collection till to the final disposal point, each and everything, the vehicles are tracked and monitored, and everything is available on the VTMS. Now this VTMS has been extended to all the cities of Madhya Pradesh, And I would say that slowly, right in 2015, when Indore started doing many of these things, today, a reduction in manual hours of monitoring by the municipal commissioner. That is, initially, municipal commissioner used to spend, let us say, 7 to 8 hours per day in this entire campaign. Now, with the introduction of VTMS and similar kind of interventions, has reduced his monitoring time, I mean his physical monitoring time, from 7 to 8 hours to 2 to 3 hours. So he needs to spend only 2 to 3 hours instead of spending actually 7 to 8 hours, which he or she used to do in Indore. Ultra-modern mechanized transfer stations. So these are the transfer stations where the vehicles do come here, and segregation, the segregated vehicles dump their waste at this particular mechanized transfer station. There are 10 such ultra-modern mechanized transfer stations in Indore. Here I would say that the distribution of all these mechanized transfer stations is such a way that it is spread in all corners of the city. Instead of transfer stations being located at particular places, the transfer stations are distributed in such a way that the vehicles don't need to travel or don't need to move too much of a distance from the source door-to-door collection points. So from the door-to-door collection points, it is ensured that to the transfer station, they travel not more than 3 to 4 kilometers. So in such a way, the ultra-modern transfer stations are actually built. This is a central waste processing unit. So these are the waste processing units where wet waste processing and the dry waste processing is also done. So these have also been developed over a period of time. Then the most important thing is about the wet waste. The wet waste is taken to the biomethanization plants. So there are two such biomethanization plants in Indore, 20 TPD and 15 TPD unit capacity. And this biomethanization ensures that the wet waste is taken care of. When it comes to the plastic that is actually collected, the plastic is, there's a plant which converts plastic to diesel in a way that it generates, the raw plastic generates nearly 3,000 liters of crude oil. So this station has also been established, and the oil that is generated out of the plastic waste is used to operate the city buses of Indore. So this is another such initiative. Then home composting. In Indore, about 28,000 households are doing home composting. So the citizens of Indore can ask for training them how composting is done. So municipal corporation actually trains citizens of Indore to do composting of their household waste. So Indore has a target about 150 tons per day reduction in waste generated by the city on a per capita basis. I'm rushing through because of paucity of time. There are so many things which can be discussed at length. There is the bioremediation. This would has been such a milestone achievement for entire Indore. And the poster that you are seeing, and this particular person with the flying wings, has become the poster for Indore being the cleanest city. So earlier, this is how it used to be. These are the the dumping yards, how they used to be. So through bioremediation process, the entire place has been now converted into a bioremediated land. And now, I mean, the most important, the the best thing that actually happens anybody coming to Indore is after a round of the city, people are taken to this particular spot where earlier it used to be a dumping yard and nobody used to stand there even for 5 minutes, now have a cup of tea or breakfast at this particular same place. And a memento is given as a token from the Indore Municipal Corporation. So in two phases, green belts have been developed and this entire place has been made scientifically green. So here, inert landfilling operation, scientifically engineered landfill filling site is being done to ensure that the land is recovered. Construction and demolition waste management is done. C&D waste of plant of 100 tons per day capacity has been established at the same place that I've been talking about, Dev Guradia. So if you see the entire story of Indore, what you will realize is there is a solution for all kinds of waste, whether it is wet waste, dry waste, C&D waste, construction and demolition waste, plastic waste. So all kinds of waste are ensured that they are properly taken care of. So this ensures that with door-to-door collection and segregation at stores and transfer and taking them to the transfer stations, we are ensuring if let's say 15 tons of waste, all kinds of waste is generated in Indore per day, at the end of the day, there is zero waste which has to be dumped at the dumping yard. So there is no need of a dumping yard actually, because now that everything is managed in a scientific manner, whether wet waste, dry waste, C&D waste, plastic waste, green waste. So there is no need of a landfill site. So the concept that we are developing in Madhya Pradesh is that in future, we don't need any kind of landfill site. So a city doesn't need a landfill site if we are able to take care of all kinds of waste that is generated from the household or from the towns. So 3G protocol, green protocol was conducted for zero waste events like IPL was organized in Indore. So it was a zero waste event. About 3 to 4.5 tons of garbage was generated during these IPL matches, which was segregated and disposed in stadium itself based on the 3R concept, which was generated, which was designed. An NGO was appointed for this particular purpose. IEC activities, major IEC activities are conducted in the entire city. Now it has become habit for the citizens of Indore. And the same thing is, which is replicated in the entire Madhya Pradesh, major IEC activities. And we all understand now very clearly that anything to do with Swachhata is a behavioral change. This Swachh Bharat campaign anta behavioral change ki sambandhinchindi. If we are able to bring behavioral change in the citizens, then it becomes their own campaign. So the public representatives, Praja Pratinidhulu, the citizens and the government officials, everybody has to come on the same platform. Everybody need to understand that how important it is to make a city clean so that, it is livable and it is in the best interest of everybody. So massive IEC camp activities are taken up, city beautification activities. Most of the cities are doing these things, whether it is graffiti or murals or slum designing, ensuring that slums are very well taken care. So these led to many awards, 2017, 18, 19, and we are expecting 2020 also make Indore the cleanest city in the country. So any questions I can take here.
సో జస్ట్ కీప్ ద మొమెంటమ్ నేను శ్రీనివాస్ చారి మాట్లాడుతున్నాను. సో ఇప్పుడు కమిషనర్స్ డిఫరెంట్ సైజ్ క్లాసిఫికేషన్ ఉంటుంది. వరంగల్ కమిషనర్ కావచ్చు, నిజామాబాద్, కరీంనగర్, కొన్ని శివార్ల మున్సిపాలిటీలో కమిషనర్స్ వీళ్ళందరూ ఉన్నారు, అడిషనల్ కలెక్టర్స్ కూడా. ఓకే, దిస్ ఈస్ లైక్ ఎ మ్యాసివ్ ఎక్సర్సైజ్. మీరు అన్నట్టుగా దిస్ ఇస్ నాట్ ఎ వన్ టైమ్ థింగ్, బట్ మల్టీ ఇయర్ ప్లానింగ్ ఇస్ రిక్వైర్డ్. టిపికల్ గా ఏంటంటే కమిషనర్ టెన్యూర్ ఇన్ ఎనీ కాంటెక్స్ట్ లో రెండేళ్ళు, మాక్సిమం 1.5-2 years, 3 years కంటే ఎక్కువ ఉండవు. ఇలాంటి కాంటెక్స్ట్ లో ఒక మున్సిపల్ కమిషనర్, ఒక అధికారి ఎలా ప్లాన్ చేసుకోవాలా? సమ్ టైమ్స్ ఇండోర్ బికమ్ సో కాంప్రహెన్సివ్ అండ్ సో గోల్డ్ ప్లేటెడ్ దట్ కొన్నిసార్లు భయం అనిపిస్తుంది, అరే మనం చేయగలుగుతామా అనే ఒక ఫీలింగ్ అనిపిస్తుంది. సో ఎనీ అడ్వైస్ టు ద ప్రాక్టీషనర్స్, వాట్ ఆర్ ద సీక్వెన్స్ ఆఫ్ వెరీ ప్రాక్టికల్ థింగ్స్ దట్ దే షుడ్ డూ so that the subsequent commissioner can take it forward? Of course, it requires a lot of state support and political support. Luckily, Telangana la anni unnai. So I think what is the role of the practitioner and the policy, the particularly municipal commissioner, anedi mee experience vara is about?
See, according to me, this is this whole thing. I mean, if somebody wants to start and actually starts doing and converting and making them into reality. See, I'm a biggest advocate of the municipal administration, and I myself was municipal commissioner of Indore in 2005-06, and later on collector, and then municipal administration commissioner. What I see is municipal administration law, you can see things happening before your eyes in no amount of time. It means it takes very little time to actually make things happen. If you take other departments like education, health, similar kind of department, other departments, to make things happen, it takes years or decades of time. Whereas in municipal administration, it is much, much easier, and it is possible that we can make things happen within a year of time. So first thing is that in that cheppinappudu kuda, most important thing is officers or municipal commissioners need to convince themselves that this is going to be my target. So now we have, as far as Swachh Bharat mission is concerned, or there is a Swachhata Sarvekshan 2020, now 2021 has also come up. The guidelines are very clear. Now everything is there in the form of manuals. So you just need to implement those manuals. Whatever manuals have been designed. So whether it is a smaller municipality or a bigger municipal corporation or mid-sized municipal corporation, things are possible to happen. Like in Indore, it happened in a 1 year time only. It happened 1 year time. And I told you that officers, public representatives, and the mayor, ward councillor, public representatives, and citizens, and apart from the citizens, also all the civic societies and NGOs, you need to ensure that citizen participation takes place. So you need to communicate with your people, all sections of people. When you communicate, and this is one thing which I have seen, that ward councillor laite, ward councillor la madhya competition pedte, nenu first vastanante nenu first vastani councillor la madhya yuddham laga jarigind anamata. So you need to create that competition among councillors also, that like Government of India is creating competition among the cities, you need to create a competition among your wards. Ward la madhyalene competition tayar chesi councillor la madhya competition tayar chesthe, this is one area where I have seen that the councillors line up asking for vehicles, asking for all kinds of facilities, and they say that my people are asking me, so my citizens are asking me, so I have to create these facilities. So this is one such field where there is a citizen based demand that their ward has to be clean and neat. So nobody wants an unclean place. Nobody wants to stay in an unclean place, whether it is poor or middle class or upper class, upper middle class or rich class. So This has to be made a citizen-driven, demanded kind of program. So once you make this a citizen-driven program, So automatically you will see that things happening. So they themselves will start monitoring. There will be people who want to monitor within their own wards and, you know, mohallas or their neighborhoods or colonies. So we have to ensure that such kind of competitive spirit comes into place and people start actually participating. So the only way to make things happen is people participation and public representatives' participation. Let them feel that this is their program. So let them feel that they are the ones who are going to take the award when the city becomes the cleanest place. So now then once it becomes pride that, you know, then people start talking that your town is one of the cleanest ones. So nobody wants the number has to go down. Nobody wants that their city has to go down as far as cleanliness is concerned. So we will have to ensure a huge amount of public participation. And I'm very sure that that leads to sustenance in the longer run. Anybody else? Any question? Or I think.
Thank you, sir. The all questions, of course, from the explanation and the answer, I need, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Very inspiring and very impressive. The presentation and also the guidance given to all the commissioners, sir. Now, and overall level, the matam, ippudu 30 commissioners, corporation commissioners, and additional collectors, kuda unnaru, sir.
Okay.
Thank you very much, sir. Ramgunam commissioner garu ikkada unnaru, sir. Thana Ramgunam ani cheptaru, sir. This is Satnaran Sinhan, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Wonderful. Definitely, this 2021 first election lo, ippudu meeru cheppina part lo, of course, end-to-end tisukovali time padutundochu. But meeru cheppinatlu door-to-door collection, soil segregation and processing, especially the composting and recyclables cheyatam, that issue was there, sir. But definitely, especially when composting also, these commissioners, they can take it up because these municipalities are and corporations, so in and around the Hyderabad, sir, they have huge potential and the people also, because the community is also organized, because strong RWS are there, and especially in the slums, we have very strong slum level federations and also the SHG is very strong. When we rope them in, kachitanga meeru cheppinatlu cheyadam kaaskaram untadi, sir. Evana malli malli doubt vaste, actually maa minister garu kuda indoor visit cheyalani anukuntunnaru, KTR garu. ఎందుకంటే అది చూడాలి ఖచ్చితంగా ఇంత బాగా చేశారని ఇవాళ చెప్తున్నారు సార్ విల్ టేక్ ద లీడ్ సార్ డెఫినెట్లీ ఐ విల్ ట్రై టు డు ద మాక్సిమం
యా డెఫినెట్లీ ఐ ఎక్స్టెండ్ మై ఇన్విటేషన్ టు ఆల్ మున్సిపల్ కమిషనర్స్ ఎవ్రీబడి ప్లీజ్ సీయింగ్ అండ్ సీయింగ్ ఈస్ బిలీవింగ్ యు మస్ట్ సీ అండ్ నౌ మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ ఇనిషియేటివ్స్ ఆర్ రిప్లికబుల్ సో వీ కెన్ రిప్లికేట్ మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ ఇనిషియేటివ్స్ సో దిస్ ఇస్ పాసిబుల్ సంథింగ్ విచ్ ఇస్ పాసిబుల్ అండ్ హ్యాపనింగ్ అండ్ I am very proud to say that more than 25 to 30 countries have visited Indore to see how Indore has actually been able to do this. So we should be very proud especially those in the municipal administration should be proud that you are actually having such a great job at your hands to look at the health and public health of the citizens of the of your place. So all the best. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, sir. Thanks a lot, sir, for your assistance. Thank you, sir.